Hello and welcome, everyone. Here we are back at some modern action for today. Today we're gonna try Jeskai Monkey Blade. With Murktide Regent. We got charms, some counter spells, the fairies, three equipments, Stoneforge. Two snaps, which I'm a little not sure on, but we're going to run them anyway. Prismatic Ending, Ragavan, Scour, and Bolt. And sideboard, two Rest in Peace, two Alpine Moon, two Wear Tear, two Gust, two Dispute, one Force Negation, and two Explosives. Yeah, let's see how this goes. And, if you guys want to see your deck on the shots, check out my Patreon in the description below. All right, we're on the play for round one here. I should probably not keep it, but we're going to keep it. I'm too greedy to put it back. Okay, well now we know they're on. They're on the Breach Embercle deck, most likely. Super annoying. Of course. Mm-hmm. Oh, maybe they're not. Okay. Alright, that's how game one goes. Moral of the story is always mill your opponent. Alright, I feel like 22 lands is not, like, too few. Right? Like... I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it is too few. Really? That's rude as hell. Opponent's not a very kind individual. I guess we should have disputed that, right? All right, if we draw another land, I think I'm gonna throw my TV or my monitor out the window. That's annoying, but sure. Alright, fucking problematic. Please draw a second removal spell. I guess on the bright side, they... So I think we're dead. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay. Batter skull. Okay. Okay. Boom. Triggers. Yep. Had to find the line, but we knew it was there. Wow, these are a Nombo with Regent. Oh, this is pull back, and we'll just run it at 61. I don't care. We're gonna mulligan. Mulligan's build character. Second mulligan, not so much character building as it is learning that some games you're just meant to lose. They also went to 5. That's good. That's good. That's good. Oh no. Oh, why? Why's it gotta go down like this, opponent? Stoneforge. Fucking kill me. Of course they have a perfect curve out. I mean... It's too bad I can't put that in play from my hand, huh? Yep, all right. Fair enough. That is a problem. Oh, that's so annoying. All right, we're keeping this hand on the draw for round two. Fetch. That was the wrong fucking land. It's fine. We'll draw another white source. See, look. Never didn't have it. So fucking lucky. Oh my god, that was so lucky. I I guess we should have grabbed sword, right, instead? Because they almost certainly have a way to kill this. Yep, they had a way to kill it. How the hell do we stop that? Do we have a way of killing this game main deck? I don't think so, right? We don't. We gotta draw a Ragavan. And now we're just dead. Notably, we drew the Ragavan. All right. Despite my annoyance at the end of that first match was actually really good. Game 2 and 3 were really good at that. All right, let's... This hand's not the hand we're supposed to keep, but I don't want to mulligan it. Run around Ragavan might be really hard for them to deal with. Especially considering a lot of times decks like these can just have super discard heavy hands. Base point basically every time we play it. Nope, I was fucking wrong. They have a prismatic ending. Bell rights where they put in the graveyard, okay. Interesting. Okay. Very interesting. Happy with our two cards we got rid of though. Yep. I'm gonna fetch and get the other and hold them up. Yep. Makes me happy. One game, two, without having to reveal the fact that we're playing Rest in Peace. All right, I mean, I give. I can't not keep this hand, right? Like, it's not great, but... I gotta have back-to-back answers. Okay, thank you. My money says they block. My money was very wrong. Although, are you worth it? No, because you can just be put in play right away without any issue. I guess we could have prismatic ending that to try and avoid them getting to reanimate something this turn. Yeah, this is pretty bad, not gonna lie. Two very, very close swift losses that, if we've been, I guess, a little more aggressive to Rest in Peace, I don't know. We should have prismatic ending it. That was the mistake. That was the mistake. There's no question. We should have prismatic ending the, reanimate creature. I don't know why I thought so much about it. There shouldn't have been a thought. It should have just been prismatic ending it. But... obviously, I fucked it up. I mean, we didn't register a Ragavan deck not to keep this hand, right? Oh fuck. Charm. Damn. All draw. Basilisk Caller. Oh, we're gonna pass. Yep. Yeah, Tron. Very well played, opponent. All right. I guess like that. These could have relevance. These could have relevance. All right, man, I'll keep. Ain't quite what I signed up for when I said we're going to register this deck, but it'll do. Oh, there, Eldrazi Tron. That significantly changes the dynamics of what I was anticipating here. That very much so risks us just being fucked, so. I actually have nothing to change. We just lose. We can't really beat this. They take Murktide in here and we're pretty dead. Or Stoneforge is pretty bad for us too. I think Stoneforge is the best choice here. Someone. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess you can say they saw it coming. I don't even know what we're looking for here at this point. Okay. Yep. Get Batterskull down to 2, grabbing an island. Okay. Yep, and this game. I don't think we're going to change anything. I don't think there's anything really worth. Alright, we're going to keep this. Okay. Yep. Okay, perfect. Tower. All right, this does work the way I think it does. I hope it does. If not, I'm upset. All right. All righty. Well, we've had some quick and swingy matches. All right, I'll risk it. We're going to risk it for the biscuit. I mean, if we get another island or another blue, at least like an island or another blue source, we can charm still too. Obviously, most of our hand is currently shut off by our weird mana base. By weird, I mean our mana base that's weird because it doesn't want to give us typical colors. You feel this is the problem I had with Jeskai controlled too a lot of times, is we had like really awkward mana bases. And awkward in the sense of how they turned out, not actually like they're weirdly constructed. Like, Bant feels terrible. Every mana base I've ever played Bant with, just because it seems like Bant's awful, mana-wise. But then we have Jeskai that just always feels like it turns out so bad. Oh, no. Oh no. Oh no. No. Blue Red Prowess is a deck I did not know I needed to be concerned for. Let's just get off the table. Next turn, we can go either hold up Archmage Charm or to play Teferi. Depending on what they do. Like, if they go Metamorphosis into Stormwing, I'm bouncing Stormwing. Like, all day. That's exactly what they're about to do. I hate it here. Fucking predictable. Blue Red, oh god, Blue Red Prize has been MIA for so long, I forgot. Like, we don't prep for it. Ever since MH2, it's been so MIA. Oh my gosh.
It sucks.
So we're gonna have our cake and we're gonna get to eat it too. Must be fucking nice. Down goes Tef. Let's try killing it. Nope, they protect it. I have land, creature, instant, planeswalker. And here's the fucking problem, though. This stupid thing I said, attack, and I don't know how we, don't die. Alright, we don't have an answer for that, which is unfortunate, but it's fine. Oh, how do we beat Stormwing Entities? Gust is fine here. Explosive, I guess, is fine here. I'm gonna cut out Snaps. Cut out Feast and Famine and a Stoneforge and run it back like this.